G'day everyone, CJ here again, and today we're our cruising Colorado challenge again. We're going from Gallup, New Mexico through Palmerton to Durango. Now there's plenty of places in Colorado we haven't visited yet, but we'll get to it. Our previous trip took us, challenge took us from Montrose down to Yuma, and then I took another trip back up to Gallup. So that's why we're here. Anyway, let's get going. We have a cargo of mortar in a container, and hang on a sec. Yeah, so a short load, which can cause a few little problems when reversing. See towards the end of the track. So this is the Beazer facility. There are actually two of them, and they're right next to each other in this town on the same road. But this one has the Cooper sign outside of it. Helps the driver identify it. Now if you look down that way, that's down towards the rail yards, and you can see a train coming out of it. So we expect the railroad crossing to be down when we get up that way. But luckily we don't need to cross the railway, so we should hopefully be okay to move on. Okay, that's the other Beazer facility. Completely separate.
Get ready to turn right.
I'm not sure why they put two of them together. Okay. So I'm going to stop. It's going to be coming from the direction. Okay, so we're driving through town. It's quite spread out, really. It's against any town, but it's got the interstate and another major road coming into it. So,
right.
I guess that's the reason why it's so spread out. Sadly, we have to wait here. A quick glance at the hotel. What's it called? Yep, iFlop. It's got an iFlop restaurant and it's the hotel inn. Slow down, but we have to stop. And we go to the room. Oh, also a burger joint and a donut shop. And we do have a fuel stop there. We're okay with fuel right now, so we need to stop there. Didn't stop there once. Getting out of there is a real problem because we're trying to map this several times. Okay, so this highway.
No strings.
There's 491. They're still working in the background on Texas, that's a huge area. We don't expect to only pay $20 for the demo suit. That's going to be kind of expensive. This is such a large area. Alright, so that's ATS. What is going to be ATS third party events and stuff like that? Version of ATS. Eventually check that. Okay, over in ATS lane, we also have data bags of 1.1. We also are anticipating the Iberia release. Maybe I think it's going to be before Christmas. We will continue in the direction of Farmington. is also another turnoff. ATS has got the pretty dumb light system. Doesn't anticipate traffic or anything, which is a bit sad. It's like lights, how lights were 30 years ago. Although, who knows, maybe it is out there. Elevation, what was it, 5,800 feet? Alright, we'll slow down just a little bit, too much there. We'll get you back down to 35. But we didn't have to turn.
Stay right, then turn right.
So it's no big problem. Okay, we refuel at the pure energy. And, I guess we've got to get out of the vehicle first. Alright, there we go. $340 worth, 149.37 gallons. Well, that was a fair amount. So, let's get out of pure energy.
Stay right, then turn right.
It's a little cloudy now. Oh, we've got traffic. So we see the bison transport. The Lamer's bus. just remind us. So we'll just go straight ahead. It's not so bad, is it? Alright. Can't quite see the name of the cross street there. Upstream.
Turn left.
In the 64 junction. Now, we're coming up to the 5 minutes south. Try to move this way.
Stay left, and then turn back.
Okay, and we want to go up the 550 north. Which is newly added in the Colorado. crossing.
Turn left.
Oh, hang back a little bit. Splitting the time. Have a look round. Yes. Move up a little bit closer. Oh yeah. Go, go. We're just gonna use. Oh, it's red. Didn't want to get a ticket there. Oh shame, but at least we can look around a bit more. It's been carried in that case. Dogs. Chickens. Probably not all of them at once. Right, green light. Until you see the traffic that was hitting the side. Okay, here we go. We are we're getting pretty close to the radio here. Mm-hmm. All right, just in case you haven't realized, I've recorded these voice tracks separately. What you'll notice up here is that I really have an issue with the short load and long. Short trailer and long truck in this reversing place. It is meant to be hard, but not how hard I make it. I think I reverse 7 times in various spots. I also decide up here that I want to turn the truck around. I probably should have just gone to the next point. But, you know, once you make the decision, that's what's happening. So we'll count the reversals. I really didn't do this well, so you could be mildly amused. Okay, going for the corner here. Up on the curb. This is reversal 1. Turning a bit much too slow. Oops, I'm there. So we're forward again. Reversal 2. Truck's too turned. I'll just straighten it. Reversal 3. Reversal 4. Reversal 5. Have I made much impression from last time? Not really. Reversal 6. You're making progress here, finally. But no, I'm too close. I have to go forward, don't I? Reversal 7, maybe? Reversal 8. Universal Ice. Who's out down low? Okay, running the trail a bit straight here. Heaps more room down here. We might have got it wrong. We're calling this reversal 11. Coming up. Get out of here. Okay, mortar delivered from Gallup to Durango. That's 160 miles. We got $4,282 and 348 XP. We did get a maneuvering bonus after all that reversal. I hope you enjoyed this trip. Until next time, CJ is out.